Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Olympic Edge. Hopefully you are will be fine. Today we are going to solve a very interesting exponential equation which is given as 1 raised to power x is equal to 4. From this given equation, we can see that it is not possible and with simple mathematics we can prove it as well. So let's take log on both sides, natural log of 1 raised to power x, 1 raised to power x is equal to natural log of 4, and this x will be here, natural log of 1 is equal to natural log of 4, and x is equal to natural log of 4 over natural log of 1, as natural log of 1 is equal to 0, so x is equal to natural log of 4 over 0, which is undefined and infinity, that is, it is undefined. So from this we can conclude that no real solution exists. Now, if there is no real solution, there must be a complex solution. Now, for complex solution, how we can calculate the complex solution of this given equation? For this purpose, we will use a second method which is given as. So, to find the complex solution of this given equation, we will use Euler's identity which is given as, according to Euler's identity, the given Euler identity is e raised to power iota theta is equal to cos theta plus iota sin theta, and from this, if theta is equal to 0, then e raised to power iota into 0 is equal to 0, which is equal to cos of 0 plus iota sine of 0. Now from this, cos of 0 is equal to 1 plus sine of 0 is 0, and e raised to power 0 is also equal to 1. So 1 is equal to 1, and it does not give us any complex solution. But if we take theta is equal to 2k pi, where theta is equal to 2k pi, where k belongs to integers and k is equal to 1, 2, 3, up to so on. For this, the Euler's identity will become e raised to power iota 2k pi, replacing theta with iota here, is equal to cos of 2k pi plus iota sine of 2k pi. So this is the Euler identity if we take theta is equal to this. Now if we assume if k is equal to 1, this implies that e raised to power, the above equation will become, putting the value of k is equal to 1, it will be e raised to power iota 2 pi is equal to cos of 2 pi plus iota sine of 2 pi. Now cos of 2 pi is equal to 1 plus iota into 0, which is equal to 1. Similarly, if we take k is equal to 2, then it will become e raised to power iota 4 pi, that is 2 into 2 is equal to 4, putting k is equal to 2 here, we get 4 pi is equal to cos of 2 into 2, 4 pi plus iota sine of 4 pi, again it is 1, and it is 0. So again it will be equal to 1. Hence e raised to power iota 4 pi is also is equal to 1. Now if we take k is equal to 3, then this term will become e raised to power iota 2 into 3 is equal to 6 pi. E raised to power iota 6 pi, which will be equal to cos of 6 pi, cos of 6 pi plus iota sine of 6 pi. Now again it is equal to 1 and it is equal to 0. So this is again is equal to 1. So from this we assume that if we take k is equal to 4, then e raised to power iota 8 pi is equal to 1. And if we take k is equal to 5, then e raised to power iota 10 pi is equal to 1. And up to so on. So from this we can conclude that the term e raised to power iota 2k pi is equal to 1 if k belongs to integers and k is equal to 1, 2, 3 up to so on. So for this, this term is equal to 1. So now from this we can see that the complex identity iota involved in this term. Hence if we introduce or replace 1 with this term in the given statement, we can find the complex solution of this equation. Now as according to given statement, 1 raised to power x is equal to 4, this is the statement, we can replace this 1 with this term. So the given statement is 1 raised to power x is equal to 4, replacing 1 with e raised to power iota 2 pi, we get e raised to power iota 2k pi whole raised to power x is equal to 4. Now this x will be multiplied with this power and we will get e raised to power iota 2k pi x is equal to 4. Now to solve this, we will take natural log on both sides. So taking natural log, we will get natural log of e raised to power iota 2k pi x is equal to natural log of 4. And the property of using property of logarithm, we will take this power behind and we will get iota 2k pi x natural log of e is equal to natural log of 4. Here natural log of e is equal to 1, so putting this value we will get x into iota 2k pi is equal to natural log of 4. Now taking this term towards the right hand side, we will get x is equal to natural log of 4 over iota 2k pi. Now rationalizing the numerator term by multiplying and dividing iota, we will get iota natural log of 4 over iota into iota 2k pi, and it will become iota natural log of 4 over iota into iota is iota square 2k pi, and iota square is equal to minus 1. So putting this value here, we will get x is equal to minus iota natural log of 4 over 2k pi, that is putting this iota square is equal to minus 1, we will get this solution. And this is the final solution of our given equation, and we can see that it is a complex solution. So By using this method, we find the complex solution of the given equation, and as in the start, we prove that the real solution does not exist. So, by using Euler's identity and some basic mathematics, we prove that the complex solution of the given equation is this, and this solution exists only for k is equal to 1, 2, 3, up to so on, and k is belongs to integer. So if k belongs to R, then we cannot use this solution, because this solution is only valid when the value of k is 1, 2, 3, up to so on, and k belongs to integer. So this is the required complex solution of the given equation, and this solution is valid only when k belongs to integers and the value of k is equal to 1, 2, 3. And after watching this video, please share with us that what happens if we take k belongs to R. Answer please in comment section. Thank you so much for watching this video, and please subscribe my channel for more interesting videos, and comment your answer in comment section. Thank you.